Well, these are just the sighting shots, of course. We're about to get underway in the men's competition, the trap competition. Number two relays, four athletes per relay. We'll get you through the rules. Everything's changed a little bit for this year and through to the next Olympics. Well, here we are then, the eight that are going to make up this men's trap competition. Lined up just in front of me, actually, waiting to be officially introduced to those here at Lunato on a chilly Friday afternoon. We have a big Croatian presence here and a big Glasnovic presence. Brothers are in the same final. This will be interesting. Anton and Josip. Here is Anton, 41-year-old. And Josip, well, 3 years his junior. You may remember the Olympic gold in Rio. A man who certainly knows his way to the top of the podium, and well, whether he can find it here is what we'll find out in the next hour or so. It's chilly. Almost put my jumper on. Oh, I know a lot of athletes from warmer climes have their hats on. Big, lots of coats as well, but well, it's shirt sleeves for this man here, Matt Coward-Holly of Great Britain, the 27-year-old, the bronze medalist, of course, in Tokyo. He'll be in this first relay as well. What happens is the first, third, fifth and seventh qualification athletes to qualify will be in the first relay, second, fourth, sixth and eighth in the second one. How about this for a reception for Giovanni Bellelio, the 52-year-old, 25 gold in his career, three times Olympic silver medalist and also a bronze medalist at the Olympic Games as well. Lovely man, very experienced, four times world champion. Home crowd will be hoping that he can do something. Second set of athletes include Eric Varga, the 45-year-old, the policeman from Slovakia. Aaron Heading of Great Britain, the man from the East Yorks Gun Club. He's in great form. He's very relaxed. Big smile. I spoke to him just before the final. He said, he's looking good. And, well, he said in his bio that he likes, his hobbies are badminton and ballet. I'm not sure he's telling the truth, but he may be. Who knows? He's certainly enjoying himself. Andrea Martinez Torres, the Spaniard, the 23-year-old, 24, his ranking in the world. He does have goals to his name. They are in the Junior World Cup, two Junior World Cups to his name. And this is Mitchell Isles of Australia. Well, we saw Penny Smith not doing so well in the women's competition. Perhaps a chance for another youngster, 23 years of age. In fact, excuse me, only just 23. I beg your pardon, a lot of coughing going on there. But yeah, an interesting prospect inside the top 30. Now, Gelfi is our jury member in charge. And this once again is Jack Birch of the United States. And I spoke to him earlier on. And our VAR official, Keith Shields, he said he's there all week. That's a good thing or a bad thing. But he is a VAR man. So here we go. Our first squad make their way to the shooting positions. Our second squad take their seats. We are underway. Anton Glasnevich, next door to him. Somebody he knows very well. Josip Glasnevich.
Oh.
That coward Holly starts with a miss and a little scowl. Well, he's going to have to go some. Remember, Kirsty Hegarty with the gold for Great Britain. In the women's competition, great start for the British team who are here in force. And a miss, second time round for Anton Glasnevich. Josip Glasnevich, just the slight advantage there. Pelliello. Lining himself up now.
Oh.
That's a new format. It's an interesting one, isn't it? Just a reminder that the first 15 targets on this relay will decide who the first athlete is to leave. Then 10 more targets.
Oh.
25 in total. Ooh, now, that looked like it took a bit of a nibble. No, it didn't. This is why VAR can be so subjective. Oh. The coach puts his hand up. It definitely seemed to have a wobble from our position. But that may just have been a mirage. Certainly the referee got it right. There was no argument. And that's three misses in a row. We've been watching there. No problem for Josip Glasnevich. Pelliello, just the one miss from him. Make that two. Jake Birch takes his time to deliberate over a miss. The hand doesn't go up straight away. He'll have a think about it as it drifts away. And he's been busy. That right, that left hand has gone up quite a lot in this first round. Seven misses from these athletes collectively.
Oh.
Better from Coward Holly. He would not be happy with two misses. Glasnevich, Anton Glasnevich with three, Pelliello with two as well, but Josip Glasnevich will be very happy with his first round of five. 10 more shots, targets to go. That's how it looks after five. A tricky one, high to the left. That just shows the class of, I say, the youngster, 27 years of age, Olympic medalist now, of course, a world champion back in 2019 here in Lonato as well. It was a very special moment for him.
Oh.
Here is the British athlete again. That was again another tricky one for him, this time away to the right and low. Remember, random one of nine tables chosen decides the angles, some of them 45 degrees, some of them zero, straight down the middle, higher or lower. Penner, the Italian coach. This is a much smoother round of five, isn't it? Seven misses in that first round. Nothing so far. I hate to put the mockers on it. Well, this man hasn't missed as of yet. Still hasn't missed. Nine out of nine. Josip Glasnovic, Olympic gold medalist, of course, in Rio. World Cup golds in LA. European champion as well. Back in the day. Oh, there is a miss. Oh, no. Look around from the referee who gave the thumbs up just to confirm he saw a little bit going off of the target. Doesn't always have to be the puff of pink powder, of course. Anything coming off the target counts. Well, it's excellent from the Croatian. Younger of the Glasnovic clan. Good crowd in, not just in the stands, but watching from behind. Not just other shooters and coaches, but they love their shooting in this part of northern Italy. They'll have come to see what's going on to get a bit of the excitement. And we are getting towards our first athlete to leave. And straight away there, Matt Coward-Holly looked around at the coach. And I think there's a little bit of to-ing and fro-ing, and I think, as I understand it, that one stays as green, not red. No need to go and look at the screen. Remember, it will go on to bib number if they are tied. At the moment, it's Anton Glasnovic, who is a little bit behind everyone else. Just keep hitting and hoping that others will falter in this run. Remember, two go through to the medal match, two fall by the wayside. Yeah, the reaction there, a groan. Not from Alberto Pierna, but from everybody behind him. They really want to see this veteran go through and win a 26th gold of his career. At the moment, it's in balance. Nicely done from Coward-Holly. Now then, Pagliello also has the disadvantage of having the lowest of the bib numbers. Josip Glasnovic has been very good all the way through. Not missed yet. Coward-Holly has, but is still in the hunt for medals at the moment. Way to the left, tricky one. but dealt with nicely. So this is an important target for Glasnevich. And that's to secure his passage through. There's your super Glasnevich, still yet to miss. Now Coward Holly. That's an excellent five from him. And Pelliello, well, it's the bib number, it's the qualification. That's actually qualified in eighth place. And he won't go any further in this competition. The bib number, the qualification doesn't help him. And he makes his way through. Fourth place in this relay, not fourth place in the final, of course. It'll be seventh or eighth place for him. And he'll take his place. The man, the policeman, four times world champion, 25 gold, four times on the Olympic podium. Excellent work. He's gone across to have a chat with our Italian TV colleagues. And the other three will get on with the next stage of the competition, which is 10 more targets, so 25 in total, and then our second athlete will leave. Ties here will be settled by a shoot-off, not the bib number. And the two athletes remaining in the competition will head on through to that medal match. So two more rounds of five. Way to the right, no problems so far. He's on a good run, but all these athletes are looking pretty smooth at the moment. Josef Glasnevich is the one who has been serene in his progress at the moment. As these athletes battle it out, the athletes in the second relay are starting to get themselves into the zone. Again, no drama so far. Only get the shotgun ready when the referee says so. Safety paramount in all these competitions, of course. Have to carry the shotguns around broken open unless you're about to take your competitive shot. Well, so far so good for all these athletes. It's an excellent quality of competition. Job here is just to get through to the next round. Remember this round of five, then another round of five, then we'll know. Took his time. And it was worth it. Anton Glasnevich putting the pressure on the other two, certainly on Coward Holly. He was across on that far left-hand side. He looks in the zone as well. They're spread out, these athletes, across these five different targets. Way to the left, and no problem at all. So far, all green in this series of five. Pressure back on Anton Glasnevich. He is a point behind. No change there. And five more targets, and we will know who's made it through into this medal match in the men's trap competition. Got Skeet coming up, of course, towards the end of the week. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. But today, tomorrow, and the day after is all about trap individual today. Then we've got mixed team and team competitions.
Oh.
Oh, that was a miss. You could see from the reaction of Matt Coward, Holly, he was not happy with that. And one of the reasons is that he is now level pegging with Anton Glasnevic. Well, that miss played on the mind, of the British athlete. No, that was a tricky old one, drifting away to the right. That's high quality. Will somebody slip up here? That was a benign one for Josip Glasnevic. He's looking very good at the top there. He will be through, but 20 plays 20. British athlete making his way around in his good time to the shooting position number one on the left-hand side. Way to the right, no problems for Anton Glasnevic. Now Josip Glasnevic. In immaculate form, yet to miss. Well, this is an important one. No problems there. Away to the left for Matt Coward Holly. One more shot before we decide who will go through. From Anton Glasnevic. Oh, now then, Coward Holly. This to make sure he makes and books his place in the medal match. And he bags it to the left. So it's not a Croatia 1-2. It is Josip Glasnevic, Matt Coward-Holly, those are the two. Anton Glasnevic just missing out by the narrowest of margins. And so we know which two from this first relay will go through. It is Croatia and Josip Glasnevic and Matt Coward-Holly of Great Britain. Third place in this relay, fifth or sixth. The final standings, depending on what happens in the next relay, going to the Croatian. What a disappointment for him. He will exit stage right, and we will prepare for our next two, next four athletes, our second squad. Confirmation of how that first one finished, but now it's another four. And that's confirmation. Eric Varga, Aaron Heading, Andrea Martinez Torres of Spain, and Mitchell Isles of Australia. Good to see Australia back. Penny Smith not making it onto the podium in the women's final, but certainly showing what a potent force they are. Good to see Russell Mark around as well. We're underway. We don't hang around. Second squad going through. Varga, Heading, Martinez, Torres and Isles.
Oh.
Mitchell Isles, the 23-year-old from Melbourne, another great prospect from the Australians. Mentioned in the women's final, they're here for 7 weeks. We're not here in Italy, going all over the place into Spain and to Granada. Miss there from Aaron Heading early on. That's best to miss early rather than later. Consistency the key, of course. Unless you are a Glasnovic, you're not guaranteed to go through this relay. 25 out of 25 shots.
Oh.
To the right, and the Spaniard has wide of the mark there. Another 23-year-old, another youngster. Another miss. It's the Australian this time. Not Varga. The man again festooned with gold. 12 of them his name, world champion. Here in Minato, of course, in 2015. Matt Cavanoli just sat down to watch this final unfold, this second relay. Guaranteed a place in the medal match. Will that translate into a medal? We'll have to wait and see. Aaron Heading, the 34-year-old from Lincolnshire, east of England, if you're not familiar. One of the flattest counties in the country. Straight down the middle for the Australian youngster. Five shots gone, five targets done. Good from Varga. The rest just scrabbling to keep up, but it's still very tight. Varga has got away well in this second round of five targets. Ooh, and another miss from Aaron Heading. Well, he will be struggling at this rate to get himself into the medal match. Two youngsters, two more experienced athletes in this second relay. That's a miss away to the right. So, Heading and Miles with the two misses. Varga, Martinez and Torres. Well, there we go. There's our first miss from the Slovakian. They are whistling through this competition, aren't they? That's another miss this time. Well, everyone's missed in this round of five. Varga, though, is looking pretty assured. Putting the pressure on the others. Oh, and another miss. Yeah, from Aaron Heading. It's not going his way at the moment. Remember, 15 targets until our first athlete leaves. We've got another round of five.
Oh.
That's another miss. Isles with two misses out of three, looking a little deflated. 23 though. Nothing. Oh. And that looked like a miss as well from Aaron Heading. He's having a torrid time. Three out of four misses. I was going to say, if you're a youngster, development's still going, isn't it? Both mentally and on the physical side of this sport. This 7-week sweep ending in Baku for the Australians will be an interesting one. We are getting a lot of reds at the moment. Isles and Heading both scrabbling to stay in this competition at the moment. Yeah, it's interesting to get inside these athletes' head to see. Oh, and another miss. And he is having a shocker of a second round here, Aaron Heading. Two World Cup golds to his name back in 2013 and 2018. A couple of bronzes as well, but he'd desperately like to be back on that podium.
Oh!
Now Isles. That's better. And that means, of course, there's a little bit of breathing space for him. He's a point ahead of Aaron Heading, who, those last three shots were a horror show, weren't they? Can he get back in this? It's not all done and dusted just yet. He will have to know that in his head as well. Very relaxed. Aaron heading into this. Sometimes helps, sometimes doesn't. There's a miss for the Spaniard. It's not all over just yet, is it? All green from Heading and a few reds from other athletes, and it could get interesting. Remember, Aaron Heading has the better bib number compared to Isles and Martinez Torres. Bib numbers relating to their qualification place. So 2, 4, 6, and 8. In the second relay, 1, 3, 5, and 7 in the first relay. Mixing it up a little bit. Wind getting up, people putting their big coats on around here. Full disclosure, I didn't bring one. Thought it would be warmer. Heading is shooting much better. Isn't that interesting how three misses in a row, followed by three greens in a row. Now then, pressure on the likes of the youngster Martinez Torres. And there you go. It's easy to say, isn't it? Take it each target at a time. But at the moment, he's struggling a wee bit. Better for Miles. Varga cruising at the head of these four. Straight down the middle. Pumped up, isn't he now, Aaron Heading? Will it be too little, too late? Down the middle. And that's better now then. Isles knows that a hit will keep him on the cusp of going through. Heading still a point behind. Interesting to see if the Spaniard can keep his composure. All green here, and it is Heading who has to make way, but he has a better bib number than the Spaniard and the Australian. So then, he's done his bit. Let's see what happens here. Martinez Torres. No, got a nibble. Had a look at our referee. He wasn't at all bothered. Oh, it might have been a no target, which may explain why he wasn't that bothered. Anyway, here he is again. Spaniard, no problem at all. And that will do it as well. And so we have 15 targets, and it is the British athlete who has to make way. It was Matt Carron-Holly who got through in the first relay, but it's not going to be two Brits. Aaron Heading takes fourth in this competition. And we'll take seventh or eighth, depending on how he compares to the other relay. That's the tail of the targets. Close, but not close enough. And those three in a row in that middle series of five really did do the damage. So then, another 10 more targets.
Oh.
And an early miss from the Spaniard. Mitchell Isles.
Oh.
What a moment it would be if he can get through. Oh, well, keeping it interesting. See the precautions Saga always takes. Which one is not too much chafing. Make sure that shotgun that just nestles in the right place. Remember the medal match to come. Goodness me, there's some experience around this arena, both the athletes, the officials, the coaches. Varga.
Oh.
7 years since that world championship triumph here in Lonato. I remember it very well. I believe it was a bit hotter on that particular day. Nice away to the left, and Martinez Torres certainly starting to find a bit of form. The last two were indeed. Tricky one away to his right for Mitchell Isles. And a Varga. Two World Cup golds in his trophy cabinet. World Cup final gold as well. Likes this shooting range. Looking very comfortable at the moment. Remember, one more round of five after this, and we will know who has made it through to the medal match. Wonderful works of art, I guess you could say, of these shotguns. This being Italy, there are a lot of manufacturers parked up behind the display area. You could spend a lot of money if you, well, like I say, not careful, but some people go here to spend a lot of money on some of these shotguns, intricately designed. And these athletes certainly in decent form here. Varga with just the one miss in this series. And just a couple in the whole of the competition so far. And that's how it stands. He's three ahead, surely a shoe-in. Tight between the Spaniard and the Australian.
Off. Oh.
And the hand goes up. Another long look from Jake Birch, the referee. Oh dear.
Oh.
No, Nicely done from Varga, looking very composed. Certainly on top of his A game at the moment. Now then, Martinez Torres knows he has an opportunity here. Three more targets for him. Maybe one or two is the difference. Oh, it'll be two. It'll be two. Mitchell Isles had an opportunity, really did. And at the moment, the odds are stacked against him. Richard Salmon. It's a long way to come, isn't it? To be disappointed at the final hurdle. A young man from Melbourne. If he doesn't progress through, will have had valuable experience at the highest level with one of the bigger crowds you will see on the circuit. Stacked behind, adding perhaps to the pressure. And that's better. Way to the left and bagged nicely. Varga. Now you trust him to do what he has to do. That was just a little puff from the corner of that rotating disc. Say a corner. Can you have a corner on a disc? I don't think you can. That one was certainly a miss. Well, is there a possibility that Mitchell Harris can get it back into this? No, is the answer. Oh, that's a shame. Three misses in the last four for him. And that is a real shame for the young man from Melbourne. Nice way to finish. He gets his pass through to the medal match and a chance to really make people sit up and take notice. Good finish from Mitchell Isles. It's not going to be enough. Couple of points adrift in the final analysis. So it is Erik Varga of Slovakia who cruises through and Adria Martinez Torres who takes his place in the medal match where they will face up against Josip Glasnevic and Matt Coward-Holly. It should be a fascinating medal match, and that is coming up in a couple of minutes' time. Whatever you do, don't go away. We might let you have a cup of tea or coffee, but don't go too far from your screen.
Ladies and gentlemen, in 3 minutes we will start another match. Gentlemen, we are going to start the 12th medal match. We finally welcome our athletes competing for the medal match here. We have in position number one, Mr. Glasnovic Josip, representing Croatia. Big applause for him.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Hives down, here we go. Medal match for the men's trap competition. And these are the four that have made it through. Josip Glasnovic of Croatia, Erik Varga of Slovakia, Matt Coward Holly of Great Britain, and Adria Martinez Torres of Spain. Who will prevail? Well, here is Glasnovic. Looked very good, didn't he? Cruise through. Varga also looked excellent. Not so many greens as Glasnovic, which is why he's got bib number two. Matt Coward-Holly has already made his way. And Adria Martinez Torres, the youngster, the 23-year-old from Spain, is there as well. Daniela Gelfi is our jury member in charge. Jake Birch is our no-nonsense Texan referee. Jake Norman Birch the second. That takes up a lot of space in a passport. Right then. Just a reminder, Keith Shield is our VAR official as well. We are ready to get underway. Eight have become four. This is our medal match. We will shoot for 15 targets and fourth place will be decided. Then another 10 targets, 25 in total, bronze decided. Shoot 10 targets further when there's just two left. So 35 in total before we know who takes gold and who takes silver. We're on a way to start. A miss from Glasnovic, who didn't miss at all, as far as memory serves, in the relay.
Oh.
Howard Holly, we're all feeling a bit chilly here. He was stood ready to make his way onto the field of play. And I looked at him and said, aren't you a bit cold? He went, no, I'm roasting. I'm not sure how that's possible. He's in shirt sleeves. But there you go. Everybody else, long sleeves. It's not the warmest. It's a bit overcast, but they've all got their glasses. Oh. Enhance the light so they can see the target better. We see it in other sports, don't we? Like cricket. Well.
Oh,
not the cheapest, these glasses, but they're worth every penny, I imagine, to these athletes. Oh. early in this medal match, but you want to get yourself in a nice run, get yourself comfortable. Martinez Tomic, 23-year-old. What a story it would be if he could top rankings here, top the podium. Remember, one of these athletes is going to miss out, but who will it be on the podium? Another miss from Glastovich, isn't it? Just such an odd thing when these athletes who have done so well in qualification. Second in qualification, top in his relay, and all of a sudden, his high standards. The Olympic gold medalist in Rio, of course, the Croatian, here he is. Sometimes it's just not your day. And that's the interesting thing about this new format, because if it's just the one final, six in it, Perhaps you just keep your form going, but you have to reset and go again. Marathon, not a sprint, especially if you factor in a couple of days of qualification as well. Well, it is only Glastovich who has failed all five in that first set of five. And Varga joins the party of misses. Only the one for him. Coward Holly yet to miss. What about the Spaniard? Ranked 24 in the world. A couple of golds, junior golds, in the World Cup in 2018, 2017. Good as well here. Josip Glasnevich, his brother didn't make it through the relay. He is struggling to get onto the podium here. Remember, 15 targets before the podium, if nothing else, is settled. No target caught. Normally we talk about the heat causing problems with targets sticking together and coming out broken. Only our second no target that we've had in both the men's and the women's trap competition. Midway through the first 15 then. Now Varga, 45-year-old, shooting well, but not as well as Coward Holly and Martinez Torres at the moment. Tricky one to the left, bagged by the Brit. Wrapped up warm. I wish I'd brought a big coat with me. But certainly the action is hotting up. That keeps us all concentrated. Coward Holly. So far, so good for him. How about Martinez Torres? Yep, straight down the middle. Not a problem at all. Glastovic, by his high status, has not been great. Let's see whether Varga can put a bit of clear space between him and the Croatian. He can. And that is a miss. A little shake of the head from the British coach. Difficult one, high to the left. Now, Martinez Torres, the youngster, goes into the lead. Took the Spaniard, it's a new junior world record, taking a junior gold in a World Cup. And that, of course, now, as ancient history, it's the senior competitions that he's interested in, and it's, I think it's fair to say, he's doing a pretty good job. Into this third round of five. After 15, we will know who misses out on the podium. At the moment, it's this man here who's struggling. He just needs to keep hitting and hoping. Tricky went away to the right, not a problem for Varga. Coward Holly. That one miss at the end of the second series of five. Nice from the youngster, Martinez Torres. Better from Glasnevich. Solid in this series of five. Maybe a little too late. And that is that a miss? Yes, it is. Well, that makes life a bit more interesting. Just the one away from Josip Glasnevich. That coward Holly started neck and neck with Martinez Torres, and at the moment, a couple of misses for him. Pulled him back down. This is an important shot. Varga knows that he's on the podium. He's been, I was going to say, flawless. Not flawless now. So, five out of five, but has he been hamstrung by earlier misses? Varga certainly cruising through to the next stage of this final medal match. And was that a miss? Yes, it was. Well, he can't believe it. Two misses out of three, and he looked like he was cruising to the medals. But because he has the lower bib number, Matt Coward-Holly misses out. What a surprise that is. He's furious with himself. But it can happen. He was, you can see here, that's after five, and that's after 15. And he was equal first after 10 as well. So it is the Brit who misses out on the podium. It's a shame for the Great Britain team because, of course, Kirsty Hegarty has the gold in the women's competition for Great Britain. The man who won the bronze in Tokyo and won the world championship here in Annato. He was a world champion, European champion, very close to being Olympic champion, all three at the same time. But goodness me, 27 years of age, he's going to have many more triumphs. Another 10 targets then, so we go to 25 before we know who's in the gold and silver battle. These athletes then guaranteed a medal. Two British athletes in the final eight, neither getting through to the podium. It's a bittersweet kind of situation, isn't it, really? You'd be pleased with qualification, not so pleased with the final stages. Sounds like it's off this five gong and straight away the coach put the hand up, but I think our referee is happy. Jake Birch, a thumbs up. It is a green after all. No need to go and bother VAR official Keith Shield.
Oh.
So he has experience at the junior level. He's shown what he can do. Will he be top of the podium? Krasnovic chasing the other two, I think it's fair to say.
Oh.
Number 25 targets is when we lose our bronze medalist. And then another 10 targets.
Oh.
Top two to battle out. And that is a miss. So the youngster will be disappointed with that. But he's still ahead of Glasnevich at the moment. Could all change, still enough targets. His calmness falling through on the shot, just as if it was just another day at the range.
Oh.
But these kind of occasions don't come up too often, especially at Lenato, one of the jewels in the crown. Of the calendar, you always want to do well at Lenato, if you can. Away to the left, that looked like a miss, and he takes his time, doesn't he? He takes his time to decide.
Oh.
But the referee was absolutely right. Vargas already getting ready for his target.
Oh.
Way to the left, not a problem at all. Into this last five before we know who takes the bronze. Air of anticipation, a little bit of tension perhaps.
Oh.
No Italian, of course, in the last three. So that's a disappointment for the home crowd. Ooh, now then, a miss. Spaniard was in such sparkling form. Just a couple of misses in the last handful of targets. Three more to go. Josip Glasnevich, who got off to a terrible start, could still yet scramble his way to the medal match. Flying high, not wide to the left, but a miss all the same from the man in the lead, still handsomely in the lead at the moment, but this could take it back to one, and it does. It's finally poised.
Followed,
as I'm sure you know, if you fire these things,
Oh. Athletes
can count the targets. They get a certain number to the left, to the right, and straight away from each shooting position. Some do, some don't.
Oh,
and that one was a horrible target. High, shooting away to the right. And this is what we're talking about. Two misses in the last four for the Spaniard. Thought about the VAR. I think he knew it wasn't going to work. So the Croatian, who has the number one club, could be coming back. A remarkable comeback. Pressure now on Martin Torres. And he shoots the last one. And it is the Spaniard who had the disadvantage of the number four bib. And he will have to make his way back. Here's confirmation. Equal on points. That misses right towards the end did for Martinez Torres. And the two athletes who were top at the beginning are the two athletes who are now sitting watching the rest of the proceedings. But well done to the youngster. The Spaniard takes the bronze medal here in Lonato. It's a case of, at the beginning of qualification, would you have taken a bronze? Of course he would have. Having been in this situation, being top of the pile with all these people watching, would you have wanted more? Of course you would. Anyway, it's Varga against Glasnevich, the two vastly experienced athletes who have made it through to their next 10 targets. So we go to 35 to decide gold and silver. Experienced coaches as well. Remember Glasnevich, the Rio Olympic champion. We've mentioned this before. It's always worth mentioning again. I would if I was an Olympic champion. Oh, there is a miss from Varga. Well, I tell you what, if Glasnevich comes and takes this gold, from the start he had, when he just couldn't seem to hit anything, it will be astonishing. And well, you have to take your hat off to him. He's not far away, is he? You wouldn't begrudge either of these athletes the gold. Varga, who loves this place, world champion here in 2015. World Cup final gold, World Cup gold. He's got the lot, apart from the Olympic gold. Well, just the one miss so far in this series of five. Remember, 35 shots. Any ties, we go to a shoot-off. No bib numbers for gold and silver. As far apart as the two athletes can get. One and five. Glasnevich is looking in good nick all of a sudden. Pressure shot for Varga to keep his nose ahead. And, well, pressure, what pressure? Last five then in this competition. At last we go to a shoot-off from Varga. It's in his hands. 1 point ahead. Four targets left. the setup. Punched. It's not probably the right word, but crouched in that position. A little less upright than this man here, Varga. Whatever works. Oh, and there we go. There's the red. That makes life a bit interesting. Three to go. Nicely done. Now, will these two go head to head all the way, toe to toe, whatever you want to, like, every expression you want to use. This is perhaps a way of saying the cream will come to the top of these two. Really are showing the class here. The top two in the first relay are the top two shooting for gold and silver. That's a very nice shawl. I'm not sure if that's just something you've had to do in the emergency cold situation. It is cold here. It's not freezing, but it's not summer, let's put it like that. Well, it all comes down to this. Who will take the gold? Can Varga level things up here? Yes, he can. So, 31 apiece, and we go to a shoot-off to decide who takes the gold here in Italy. Our referee, the American Jake Birch, just making sure everything is okay. You can see a little signal. They're just going back to get some more shotgun cartridges. Because you never know. Shoot-offs can go on for a while, especially with two athletes as experienced and as calm as they are. So it's Josip Glasnevic against Erik Varga.
In a couple of minutes, we are going to be ready for the shoot-off for gold and silver.
Always a danger when there's no action. Could be picked out in the crowd for your big moment. Sudden death, shoot off, one misses, one hits, that is that done and dusted. So the pressure really is on. Most athletes, I think, would like to go first, and the man with the bib number one is going first, and that is Josip Glasnevic. And remember, he was rock bottom of the four after five targets. He really had struggled, and you thought he was going to be fourth. Oh, hello, a miss. Well, I was going to say, perhaps he can come back and take the gold. Well, that all depends on Erik Varga here. Can the man from Slovakia wrap it up in the first of the shoot-off targets? He can! Well, how about that? Josip Glasnevic for Tuthen now to get into that gold and silver competition from a poor start, and he did it, but well, again stumbled first time in the shoot-off. He will take silver. It is Varga who will take his lucky 13th gold of his career. Fabulous competition Eric Varga, the 45-year-old, the world champion here in Lonato, takes the World Cup gold here in 2022. And these are our medalists in the men's trap competition. Adrián Martínez Torres, with his first senior medal, takes the bronze for Spain. Josip Glasnovic at the last has to settle for silver for Croatia. And the gold goes to Slovakia's Eric Varga.
Oh.
Oh.